After building 50 plus Shopify stores, I gather up the best mobile tips that I can find. So in this video, I want to give you everything that you need to know to make your store look better than ever on mobile. But first, only 17% of you are subscribed to our channel. Subscribe now. We're trying to reach 50,000 subscribers by the end of this year. And towards the end of this video, I'm going to introduce you a tool that's going to make your mobile version just super easy. So stick around for that. So tip number one is responsive design, just in general. Something that I think a lot of people do tend to miss is the fact that within your theme customizer, you have the ability to look at the mobile version of your store. And one of the key factors of improving your mobile store is just knowing how it looks. So switching the toggle view from desktop to mobile will give you actually a better understanding of how it looks. Now, I would not say that this is the end all be all when it comes to making sure that you're checking and potentially making some tweaks to your store for mobile. Now I'm gonna show you exactly where it's at. So right now I'm in the theme customizer, and obviously at the very top over here we'll have the desktop version, we have the mobile version, and then we have a full screen view that gets rid of the sections here on the sides. But what we want to do is to click on the mobile, and after you've built everything, every single section here within your store, you've built your home page, you've manipulated your product pages, you've added the sections on the collection page, you want to go and view your whole website on this mobile view right here. Now the only thing that I don't like about this mobile view, and this is the extra tip that I'm going to give you, is that the length of this page right here is obviously a lot taller than any other typical phone. So as you can see, like, I can see make announcement all the way up to the very top of multiple collections up here. So typically this is not going to be how the actual phone looks like. So my number one tip is go through your whole store with the mobile view, make any adjustments or changes that you need to make. But after you're done with that, then open it up on your actual phone, on your actual device, and browse through every single page to make sure that you're seeing the exact same experience. Because for example, right here on this page, we have this chat button up down here. And then we have these two button labels right up here. It may be that on our actual phone, all these sort of things are jumbled together, right? You don't want things to be jumbled together or things on top of each other that don't need to be on top of each other. Obviously this button is always floating, but if you look at it from here, it just looks like, oh yeah, this looks nice. First impression, I see the big image, I see my two buttons, like everything is clear and concise, and at a glance, the store looks perfect here. But when you actually load it on your phone, that chat button may be on top of those buttons, covering important things, etc. So it's always good to look at both. Definitely work through this version of it, and then go on your phone and browse through every single page. Now, the second tip that I have for you is image optimization. So having high quality images is obviously essential for showcasing your products and making them look good on your store. However, they can also slow down your mobile store if the images are not optimized correctly. So you definitely want to use some tools to compress, potentially resize images. That way you're not blowing up everyone's like mobile version of your store. So a couple tips here is anything that's actually photography. So straight up photography, there's no layers on top of this with text layers or anything like that. That should be JPEG. And then anything that has actual text, maybe you've added some graphical elements, maybe you have the model on front of some kind of cool background, those types of images should be PNG. And that's how I call it, PNG. It could be PNG, I don't know. I call it PNG and JPEG. And the next best thing that you can do is use a tool, something like bulk resize photos, where you can actually upload your images in here and actually specify how big or how large the file size is going to be. So I think in terms of pixel wise, like, you know, 3000 pixels by 2000, like that is really not the case here or what we're looking after. What we're looking after is the final weight of or how big this file actually is, and not big in sense of pixels, but big in sense of kilobytes. A good rule of thumb, and again, this is like one of those things where I say rule of thumb, but always you can go a little bit higher or a little bit lower. It's around that 200 kilobytes, and trying to hit around that 200 kilobyte. Obviously, the best thing that you can do is always go to your GT Metrics report or Google PageSpeed Insights. And in there, it will actually give you a breakdown of each image inside of your store and how it can be compressed even a little bit further. So it will give you, this image right here is 241 kilobytes, but you may need to, or you can actually bring this down to like 173 kilobytes. So these page speed apps out there will actually give you some good actionable data for certain images and certain elements within your store. And obviously, just to show you here, bulk size resize photos, you go images, you can select your image. So let's say I have this one right here, and then you can actually click on file size and then select that to around that 200 kilobyte threshold. So it will stay around that 200 kilobyte. And then you can also manipulate the image quality. What I like to do here is test a couple images at a time, and then you can actually do the bulk where you can do every single thing. But you can always tweak, you know, the size and the image quality a little bit. You don't want pixelated images or very blurry images. You still want something that looks good and high quality, but making sure that you're saving as much or compressing as much of that file size as you can while still looking pretty good. And as you can see, I have GC metrics here just to kind of show you an example. Right now, this particular website, the total size of just the homepage, it's 7 megabytes. So it's absolutely huge, but this will give you actually, like, you know, some of the first are JPEG images. It will give you the transfer size. So these are about 300 kilobytes, 200 kilobytes. So these images being somewhat around that threshold is good. It may mean that they have just a lot of those 200, 300 kilobyte images on their homepage, and they may just need to reduce how many images or how many sections they have within their homepage. And obviously there's a little bit of room for improvement here for compressing some of these images. So that would definitely be my go-to in order to make the mobile side of the store load a lot faster. Hey, if you're enjoying the content so far, I have a doc for you that has all of our recommended apps, everything, every single video that we created around apps and some additional ones that you may have never heard of. We have it in one doc. All you have to do is comment apps down below and we'll send that over to you. Tip number three is having a streamlined navigation. So a cluttered or confusing menu could frustrate mobile shoppers. And here's what I would do to potentially simplify or group different things in terms of your menu. So again, we can always go here to the mobile version of it. Obviously, you know, we do sometimes a lot to make sure that, for example, for this page, that every single menu item falls under one line, for example. But then when we come to mobile, obviously it's gonna be a completely different experience for the customer, because they'll very, very much highly likely that they will click on a, I would say 99% actually, they'll click on some kind of hamburger menu where they actually click on it and drawer comes through and it shows them the navigation right here listed the way it is. Now, unfortunately, there's no way very easily, right, to have different menus for mobile and for desktop. But that's why I a lot of times just want to encourage the drop down navigation within the menu ecosystem, because it just makes it on mobile as well just a lot easier to have more links, and on desktop OS, have more links and still group them into good categories. So in order to do that, so if we click on header, we'll have the main menu here and we can click on it and this will open a new tab. But we're really just right here under online store and then navigation. Now, something that I always recommend is making sure that you have your new arrivals, your best sellers, have collections, but then breaking down other things. So for example, like under collections, we could have a Halloween collection and then we could have a fall collection. Right within, you know, that same sort of drop down. So in order to do that, we can go here and do our fall collection. Let's say that this is the fall collection. We can add it. What we can do is that we can grab, we can pull it up, and then we can go in. So you see that little circle that appears? That means that this fall collection is going to be a drop down under your collections menu. So you're essentially adding some sub menu navigations to make it easier for customers to find more things, but you're still keeping it concise for your desktop and for mobile as well. And then you can actually do this two times. So if inside a fall collection, for whatever reason, I have maybe a, I don't know, pre-fall collection, I'm just going to do a random collection here. Add, we can go again, do it one more time. So you can actually have a good, pretty good breakdown of almost all your products and even broken down into different areas. So I like to always do, obviously, my normal product categorization of these are tops and bottoms and whatnot, but then also doing categorizations like collections. So this could be, you know, beach ready collection, this is the fall collection, this is whatever. And then always doing some sort of new arrivals or bestsellers. And you could even do some sub menu navigations within those as well. Products may show up on a lot of different collections, but that's because you want the customer to be able to just explore and find products however they like to explore products on your store. Another quick tip for navigation is to make sure that you enable search, especially for mobile. You enable search for your customers to make it easier, again, to find products right there within your store. We're using here the Aurora theme, and they have it by default turned on. So you see search and then most search. You can also change that right within here, which is pretty great. Now, tip number four is having actually mobile optimized content. So let's talk about that. It's important to make sure that your product descriptions, blog posts, and other content looks great on mobile devices. So you definitely want to keep your paragraphs short and scannable, using headings, using bullet points for easy readability, especially for mobile. So testing different font sizes to ensure the text is legible on smaller screens is going to be very, very important. And previewing your content on mobile to just catch any sort of formatting issues. In here, we're really talking more so, like if we go here to our product page, go here, and as you can see, so for this particular product, we have like just two paragraphs in here. I'm not using any sort of italics or bold or any bullet points to really highlight anything for the product. And on mobile, it just really shows, right? And a lot of people are just gonna scroll past that and not even pay attention to it. And a lot of people tend to, you know, do some really big product descriptions that on desktop, they may look great, but a very long and big product description here on mobile, it's just gonna add a lot of scrolling to your customers. So always making sure that your paragraphs are concise, that you're using bullet points, that you're using bold, that you're using italics to highlight different parts of it is going to be very, very important. Hey, if you're enjoying this so far, please consider liking and clicking on that subscribe button and turning on notifications. Now, beyond just like the actual like text content and making sure that it looks good on mobile, something else that I would definitely recommend is getting yourself a theme that supports or gives you the ability to make some good mobile revisions. So for example, I'm using here Aurora, and for example, I can go here to the slideshow, and something as important as having a different image for desktop and a different image for mobile, there's a lot of themes out there that doesn't even give you this very basic thing, which is having a desktop image and having a mobile image. So having just the difference between the two is going to be very important, especially for this big banners that you want that customization from desktop to mobile. And then beyond that, obviously you have controls both for desktop and mobile for a lot of different things here, right? For the width, for spacing, for alignment, content, yeah, for buttons, etc. So get yourself a theme like Aurora where it gives you a lot of these options for both desktop and mobile. And that's very simple. Just like install the trial version of the theme and then just click on some of the sections and just see what options does it give you. If it separates, right, the desktop and the mobile for a lot of the different things like images, sizing, spacing in between sections, alignment, all those things are gonna be very, very important if you want a good mobile experience. Now, let's say that you already paid a lot of money or recently just paid a lot of money for a theme and they don't provide a lot of these customizations between desktop and mobile. I got you. Something that you can install is a sections app. So for example, I have here pulled up, it's called Section Store. So it's all it does is it just adds some additional sections to your already built theme. And it gives you, depending on the app, it gives you a little bit more granular control over certain sections for mobile or desktop. The good thing about these apps too is like a lot of them are free to install and you just pay for the sections that you actually want to use and you're not stuck in a sort of long-term monthly payment plan. Now this one, Section Store, I have installed here and I'm using it on the Dawn theme. So I just kind of pulled up a free, so they have a couple of free sections that you can try out. This is one of the sections that I recommend a lot if you've watched any of my other videos, which is this confidence booster or trust badges section. As you can see here, it's SS feature number one, and we have them stacked here on mobile. And as you can see, I actually have some granular control over the font size. So that's very important if I want it, you know, different from desktop to mobile. So I can actually tell them that maybe I want it a little bit bigger, a little bit smaller in terms of that. And for example, if I wanted to show or display all the features in one row on mobile, I don't think it looks the greatest, but it still, you know, could be an option for a lot of you. Obviously we would have to make some adjustments to actually make this look good like this for mobile. But again, for each section, obviously they have just different options for both desktop and mobile. So it's always good to check out some of the free sections, install them, and then you'll see how granular the control is for each of these sections. But again, it's just another option for you if you don't want to necessarily pay for a brand new theme that includes a lot of these mobile revisions already. Now remember that visually appealing and user-friendly mobile stores can lead to higher conversions and happier customers. If you're interested in higher conversions, then you need to check out this video over here next.